In this video, I'm going to show you how to add any webmail email account into Thunderbird and send or receive emails. So without wasting any time, let's get started. Alright, so here's my Thunderbird, and as you can see, I've already added many different emails here. On the right side, you can see my emails. Now to add your webmail account, you first need to log into your hosting. I'm using Hostinger, but it can be any hosting. The process is the same. You need to find the email tab. You can see my different domains here. I can either click on this manage button, or from the left sidebar, go to the emails. Then click on this manage button, which is right in front of my respective domain. After that, click on email account. You can see my email address is here, and I want this email address to be configured in Thunderbird. I'm gonna click on these three dots and select access webmail. I'll have to log in. And here's my webmail. Now, some webmail accounts, when you log in, they provide a welcome email which contains the incoming server and outgoing server information, which is very important when adding email account into the Thunderbird. But I'm not seeing any such email in Hostinger in this case. But don't worry, I'm gonna show you a solution in a minute to find that information for any hosting company. Inside Thunderbird, when I click on the inbox, you can see these emails. But if I click here, then it's gonna show this page, and here it says set up another account. Click on email, and here I'm gonna put my new email address. I'm gonna put my password. After that, click on configure manually. Now this is very important. It's asking for the incoming server and outgoing server information. For the protocol, you have two options, IMAP and POP3. If you don't know about this, then make sure to choose IMAP without hesitation. Then for the host name, as you can see, the Hostinger is using Titan Webmail. So I'm gonna go to the Google and search for Hostinger email configuration for Titan. Now, if you are using any other hosting, then you need to search email configuration for that particular hosting. For example, email configuration for Bluehost, InHosting, or any other hosting that you're using. Click on the official hosting website page. And if I scroll down, then you can see our required information here. Here we have the incoming server, our required port number, and the host name. I'm gonna copy it, go back to the Thunderbird, and paste it here. Port number is 993. Next, it's gonna auto detect these two. Now for the outgoing server, we need the host name. Under the outgoing emails, here's the host name. I'm gonna copy it, and paste it here. Outgoing port is 465. After that, click on retest to check the connection. And it's working. Click on done. And the email account is added successfully. Click on finish. And here you can see it added along with my other email accounts. Alright, let's send an email to make sure everything's working. Click on new message. I'm gonna send the mail to my other email address. Let's type a subject. And in the body, I'm gonna put email configuration with Thunderbird test 1. Now you can use all these formatting tools to change the text as you want. You can add a CC and a BCC. And also attach files from this button. After that, click on send, and the email has been sent, which I just received on my other email account. It's funny, isn't it? If I go to the send folder, then you can find the email that we just sent. Now, if I go to the Hostinger webmail and reload the page, then inside the send folder, you can also find the sent email here. Now, let's do one more test. If I go to my other email account, and I'm gonna send an email to our newly added email account, Thunderbird email configuration test 2. Just gonna copy and paste it here. After that, click on send. And the email is just received in the new email address. You can also see a notification in front of the inbox folder. Now if I go back to the Hostinger webmail, then you can see that we have also received the email here. So it's syncing the emails between webmail and Thunderbird that you can access from both. So Thunderbird is a very good application to manage multiple email accounts in one place, and it's totally free. You can donate to them if you want. And if this video was helpful, then please give it a like and subscribe to help me reach 2000 subscribers. Take care of yourself, and I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.